yet that we are the body of Christ. Now, many times the saints are thinking that he's way up there and we're down here, and we forget what the cross was about. The cross was because God loved us so.
Yes.
He wanted to dwell in us. See, he already had dealt with the Ten Commandments, where you go where his presence was. You know, you had that little time, the Holy of Holies. But the whole cross was for God to be with us and to dwell with us. And so we remember what John the Baptist said. He said, God told me that the dove lands on him, he is the Son of God, my Son. Yeah, that's, you know. Yeah. So what, he started that walk. Once he was born, amen, God with us.
Yes.
A hope of glory. And so he's never left. Amen. Isn't that something
very
wonderful?
Very
because we tend to think, in position-wise, he's up there and we're here, and one day when we leave, we're going to see him.
Yeah.
And that's not a true statement. The word says, I live and I move and I have my being in Christ. So that's what we do. That's how we live. And we thank God for Calvary, because we shall never see death.
Amen.
Now that's what the cross was about. So we still have our thoughts. We have our superstitions and what have you. But that is why the Holy Spirit, God the Father and God the Son, are so among us.
Yes.
Because Christ gave his life. God gave his Son. His Son gave his life that the Father and him and the Holy Spirit would dwell in us, around us, and among us. And so if we should ever see death, we would be men most miserable. See, because it was defeated on Calvary. And that is a great inheritance for us. You know, how many times have we had that out-of-body experience? You brought
this. Yes, amen.
You, God's coming to get you. He gets you. He takes you. Took you to see hell. He takes probably different places during a lifetime. Prophet Gares, yourself. He's come and talked to you.
Yes.
Told you about a covenant he made with you.
Oh, yes.
All the, yeah. How could this be? If he's forever up there? No. We are benefactors of all that he is. So what happens? We cheat ourselves. We don't recognize the gifts. We don't recognize our blessings. You know. We don't recognize his presence.
Yeah.
You know. So we live very poorly. You know. So if I'm talking to God, I can walk around my house. I can talk to him. I can feel his presence. When Bora prays, I know she has to feel his presence. And the Holy Spirit is guiding her on what to pray for, because, see, she's dealing with a universal body. I don't care where her physical location is, she's in Christ.
Amen.
So you're going to speak tomorrow. Yeah. Amen. We have an evangelist. So you're speaking tomorrow. And so you are in Christ. He's going to speak through you. There's going to be this anointing. Amen. And everyone in that building don't necessarily have to be in him. Just those that are part of him. Amen. But everyone will physically hear. amen, and have a chance, amen, to be blessed by your word.
Amen.
But if the Holy Spirit does not draw them,
yes,
they cannot come.
That's true.
And that's the same with us.
Mm-hmm.
We boast, so we say, I remember the day I made Jesus my choice. No, you didn't make nothing your choice. You remember the day that Christ drew you.
Mm-hmm.
Huh? Holy Spirit came and got you,
mm-hmm,
baptized you into, amen, that great family. And so, because of his presence, and because we are family, and because of who he is, what he purchased, which was us, that we can say, I'm blessed today.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
That we don't live in darkness.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. We live in him.
Mm-hmm.
And so I pray that we keep that knowledge and not always be looking up, look around.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Amen. It's good to look up, but Christ in us, a hope of glory,
mm-hmm,
is what we need to live with,
yes,
today. We live in,
amen,
him.
Yes.
And so if death has any power,
mm-hmm,
then the cross was in vain. And so that's, you know, what I want us to really think about, because we in a time whereby,
mm-hmm,
death is going to take a walk.
Mm-hmm.
In many homes, many countries, many places,
mm-hmm,
the young, the old, amen. God is reaping, amen, and the grave will have some victory.
Yes.
Amen. Because everybody does not belong to God. Now, we wish,
well,
they did.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. But if everybody was going to eventually belong to God, we wouldn't have the fight. We wouldn't have the conflict.
Mm-hmm.
Christ dies at some point. Everybody's life, they're going to come to Christ. Nice little story. No more.
Mm-hmm.
That's the end of that. Why? He ended with his body. He equipped the church. What is the church? His body.
Yes.
His bride. His purchase. That's,
yes,
what his book. He said, but I didn't leave them in the dark. I equipped them.
Mm-hmm.
And so if you cut off the arms, it don't mean I'm going to pass away,
mm-hmm,
physically.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm armless. I can't do nothing. I can't hold nothing. I can't. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
You cut off my feet, I'm going to need some crutches to get about, or a wheelchair or something.
Yeah.
You know, but it does not mean that I cannot live. Christ has a perfect body. He put it together. It is going to do that which he purposed it to do.
Amen.
He will not have a sick body,
uh-huh,
and he will not have an imperfect body.
Yes.
But we need to know, and we need to understand, that no news should catch us unaware. I'm saying this because he said in the last day,
yes,
people would be hearing things that would blow them away.
Yes.
That should not be us. Because,
mm-hmm,
we were already told.
Yes.
What? Do you know the prophets?
Mm-hmm.
They said, huh? What did God, mm-hmm, say? They speak for me.
Mm-hmm.
The mind of God. So, you in a church. You belong to a group of wonderful brothers and sisters.
Mm-hmm.
And they recognize no parts of the body, not the prophet, not the teacher, not the evangelist or the pastor, or they want to say,
mm-hmm,
what can operate in their building, or then,
mm-hmm,
you're crippled.
Mm-hmm.
I stand on that.
Yeah.
I'd say that to the whole world. You are crippled.
Mm-hmm.
God created. He has a perfect body.
Mm-hmm.
Whose body are you? Do you know who you are? You see?
Mm-hmm.
So today, we stand for God. He says, don't get faint-hearted when the prophets tell you what is going on. Things that have not been revealed before. Mm-hmm. Horrors that you've never seen. Cruelty that you know nothing about.
Yes.
Indifference for me. And what people call love. We love to use that word, God. Yes. He said that was what's cold.
Uh-huh.
You see? Mm-hmm. Love.
Mm-hmm.
Love will compel you to do that which God has given you. Love will give you courage, even if you have to stand alone. Mm-hmm. Love will let you cut loose those things that are dear to your heart. Love will push you to go when you'd like to stay in bed.
Mm-hmm.
Love will allow you to share everything that you have for the cause of Christ. Love is not attached to things. Love is attached to the souls that you pray that God saves. Love will keep you on your knees, amen, for that family member, that neighbor, that brother, that sister. Love will allow you to give, amen, until you can't, until you spend. Love. Because remember, the purchase of the whole body of Christ was already paid for on Calvary. You don't have to give your life, amen. Your blood won't save nobody.
Mm-hmm.
But love just puts you in service to God and to his people. Not a building.
Mm-hmm.
Not a name for yourself. Not any of those material things. If God owns the world, it means we are already rich in him. If we own anything today, we are only stewards, but we fight and put, we die, and we hold, we bank accounts, cars, house. I mean, we can't hardly leave here because,
It's true.
That's how we die, as we say, and I don't mean death. I mean the flesh.
Mm-hmm.
Even though when we leave here, this is just true wealth.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And isn't it strange that we can, you know, we get it going. When I see Jesus, I mean, we can speak in tongues and we dance. Woo! And when the doctor says you're going to surely die, you say, huh?
That's right.
Come on. Huh?
Amen. Jesus.
These bodies, they'll be wrecked with pain.
Yes.
Huh? We're taking pills to wake us up. Pills to think. We got a pill to go to bed. Then we got a pill to go to sleep. I mean, the body will not function on its own. And we say, oh, when I see Jesus. But when the doctor said, you're getting ready to see him, we say, not yet. Love him, but not. Praise God. Huh?
It's true.
We've got to come. Amen. To a reality in God. Amen. That we become stewards and not owners. See, we, the body of God, we stewards. Now the world might own, Satan folks may own some. But us, we are stewards, and we are stewards for service. Because the love of God will constrain you. Amen? It will, and to recognize him. You see, we say, I've been enlightened.
Amen.
prophet come among us. We don't know them from the man cross street, that's the living man. He just walked right on. In fact, Jesus, I'm sure, he said, now, be careful how you entertain strangers. And I know he's going to have a story to tell when we all get to heaven. He's going to say, you remember, Barbara, you passed right by me. Barbara, you were so busy sweeping and dusting, and I was right out there looking hungry. You never said a word. Never said, I mean, you were busy. Huh? So we as God's body, as God's body, he's not keeping anything from us. Have you seen him? I want to know, have you seen Jesus? Have you seen him? Prophet, have you seen Jesus? Have you talked? Have you crossed Jesus this week? Have you, prophet, be, and have you heard from Jesus? Have you, prophet Martin, have you? When's the last time you talked to Jesus?
Amen.
Jesus was at Washington Park. Amen. When we used to go down there, Prophet B. He was right there talking to us. And we were so holy. We were so saved. Oh, thank you, Jesus. We told Jesus just to sit over there and wait until we got the food ready, and we would serve him when we got ready. Amen. Because we think more of ourselves than we ought to. Why? Because God is using us. You know, maybe one day Prophet Tony went past a little sick lady and just laid her hands, lady got well. Father Tony went on over and sat down. Amen. Now, she thought she was sitting by one of them old members, but Jesus was right there. And because she felt so good about the healing, she ain't noticed Jesus sitting right there. We do that. Yes. I want you to hear me. Because we, the church, have not come into a reality of who we are and who God is. Amen. And if we are Christ's body, why are we worrying the government about what they do? We are from another world. You understand me? So now if I am a steward, and God has given me a home, that becomes my equipment to be used in his service. So it means when the man on the street knocks on my door, I ought to be letting him in, because that's just equipment. I ought to be feeding him. You understand? Because I'm just a traveler. You see? Here. So how do we feel about what God has given us stewardship over? We like the word ownership now. I tell you, we will go to court, we'll get up and, we will fight. But see, when God gives you something, he has a right to shifted around. I thought I owned that 10-room house. Lord have mercy.
Yeah.
If I don't have another house, that it was it according to world standards. 10 rooms, brand new, different windows, Cadillac over here, the Lincoln was here. Wow. By the world standard, I had arrived. But 3 years later, after God told me what he was going to do, I'm taking it out. I just cried for a couple of days because 3 years ain't got here yet. Amen. 3 years, what he gave me, he took back. He wanted me to understand I may not have lived in a tent, but I was still just traveling through. And everything that I thought I owned belonged to him. And he had a right to give it. He could take it and give it to whomever he pleased. Once you come to that, once you come to that idea that everything you have is equipment, then you can serve the body. But until you, see, even those ministers, and I speak for those all over the world, none excluded today. When you think you own the church, you own the people, they are your you need to bend the knee. You are only the shepherd, the earthly shepherd, or the leader, or you've been entrusted with those souls that Christ died for, since your blood won't be saving nobody. Amen. So I say that to say this. We have been warned. See, hear the word. Amen. And it told us all through here where we've been. It tells us where we're going. So today, when you hear about gay marriages, so they say. See, to me, the word gay means affix. Yeah. Hey, praise God. Yeah. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. So, it's same-sex marriage. Amen. We know today that the government has done something that's illegal in the body of Christ. There can never be a marriage between two men and two women. Mm-hmm. There can be a life partner. Mm-hmm. You can have a life partner. You can have a life friend. But there can never be marriage. Amen. This book said a marriage has to be between a man and a woman. Mm-hmm. Now, it'll be the church that will have more garbage going on about that legislation. Mm-hmm. I have no problems with it. Mm-hmm. Why? Because it's the sign of the times. Mm-hmm. It's God said that men will call,
that's right,
they will call wrong right, mm-hmm, right wrong. Mm-hmm. Huh? Mm-hmm. They will fulfill every imagination of the what? Flesh.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. So why get all blown away?
That's
about that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But one thing you cannot judge, and that's the people. Mm-hmm. So see, that's what the church will do. Mm-hmm. They will take on the people. No. Mm-hmm. No. See, it's something about the blood of Jesus. Mm-hmm. It covers. Amen? Mm-hmm. So if you think that God has no love for those people because of a flawed body or you got no talk coming. We need to stay out of that. Mm-hmm. How was I saved? I was saved by grace. Mm-hmm. That's how the other man gets saved. That's how homosexual gets saved, if that's what they want to call. God, what did he tell Moses? And that's why he put it that way. We don't like to say that. The church doesn't like. We like rules. Mm-hmm. So we can point people and put them in hell. Point to others and put them in heaven.
Yeah.
What did he say? He said, I love. Mm-hmm. I want you to understand this, Moses. Mm-hmm. I love you, but I want you to get back now. Huh? Mm-hmm. I love who I want to love. And I have mercy. Strange he used that word. Mm-hmm. I have mercy on whom I please. And what does that mean? Mercy is giving to you that which you do not deserve. Mm-hmm. So God, I know today I'm a mercy person. Mm-hmm. I know that I did not deserve your salvation. Mm-hmm. I couldn't work on it. I could never attain to it. I couldn't get good enough. I could not pray enough. But I know that mercy, huh? reached down and got me one day. Huh? And say, you saved me. I mean, you gave me the right of citizenship. Israel, I have that right.
Mm-hmm.
You gave me the benefits of the cross. I was miserable, naked, wretched, and undone. Mm-hmm. And if you had not come in my life, mm-hmm. I would not be speaking today about you. I would have no knowledge about who you are. Mm-hmm. But I'm engrafted in, I'm a part of you. I've had a blood transfusion.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Amen. And that means that love must rule my life. Everybody don't need to have a paper. Did you see what the government did? When way over here you said, this day is coming.
Yes.
You said, this day is coming. You said, my body, those of us that I love and those that make up my body, you will never be caught unawares. Mm-hmm. What is wrong with us? Who's hearing from God? We need to love our brothers and sisters. And when we come to the point that we think we are great enough to judge anyone according to sexual preference, we need to think again. So a lot of people will disagree with me, and that's okay. I don't mind disagreement. I know who I am today. I know what love is. I know who love is. And I thank God today that not only mercy has pleaded our case, mm-hmm. but love lifted us.
Yes.
And so we are obligated. We are obligated. Huh? When Jesus sent his leaders forth, he says, remember, love them as I have loved you. Huh?
Mm-hmm.
So when God snatched us, he fully equipped us, amen. He covered us, our imperfections, and we became as he is. So what a miracle today. I'm a miracle. Thank you, God. I'm a miracle today. But I say to the whole world, if you have not come into the knowledge of the equipment God gave the church, which is the gifts, not only of the apostle, the prophet, the evangelist, the pastor, the teacher. If you have not come to your insides working, that gift of administration, that gift of healing, you see, that gift of discernment, gift of prayer. If you haven't come to that, you still are crippled. You're crippled. But God the Father, giving the Son on the cross in the sonship, will not have an imperfect body. He equipped us with everything we would need. So if you say you can operate without your intestines today, glory to you. You're great. You're different. If you say you cannot, you can operate without the stomach or without the mouth to chew the food or without the legs to walk. If you can operate that way today, good for you. You're not a part of the body of Christ. I'm talking about the body of Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody don't need to have a paper. Did you see what the government did? When way over here you said, this day is coming.
Yes.
You said, this day is coming. You said, my body, those of us that I love and those that make up my body, you will never be caught unawares. Amen. What is wrong with us? Who's hearing from God? We need to love our brothers and sisters. And when we come to the point that we think we are great enough to judge anyone according to sexual preference, we need to think again. So a lot of people will disagree with me, and that's okay. I don't mind disagreement. I know who I am today. I know what love is. I know who love is. And I thank God today that not only mercy has pleaded our case, but love lifted us.
Yes.
And so we are obligated. We are obligated. Huh? When Jesus sent his leaders forth, he says, remember, love them as I have loved you. Huh? Mm-hmm. So when God snatched us, he fully equipped us. Amen. He covered us, our imperfections, and we became as he is. So what a miracle today. I'm a miracle. Thank you, God. I'm a miracle today. But I say to the whole world, if you have not come into the knowledge of the equipment God gave the church, which is the gifts, not only of the apostle, the prophet, the evangelist, the pastor, the teacher, if you have not come to your insides working, that gift of administration, that gift of healing, you see, that gift of discernment, gift of prayer, if you haven't come to that, you still are crippled. You're crippled. But God the Father, given the Son on the cross in the sonship, will not have an imperfect body. He equipped us with everything we would need. So if you say you can operate without your intestines today, glory to you. You're great. You're different. If you say you cannot, you can operate without the stomach or without the mouth to chew the food or without the legs to walk, if you can operate that way today, good for you. You're not a part of the body of Christ. I'm talking about the body of Christ. It's what from Genesis to Revelation. We have no excuses. We have none. And everybody today, when they're speaking about bygone days, they'll say, you know, from the time of Adam, now you need to leave Adam alone. See, God ended that with the flood. You want to talk about your forefather? You better talk about Noah. Huh? God ended all that inter-spiritual beings and earth beings and Satan trying to start a race. God ended that. Six people showed up after all. What was it? Eight people.
Okay.
Now we had eight. Everybody else is gone. And God starts over again. When you're reading that book, what do you see? Six. Angels that were marrying the daughters of men and all that, that was gone. Eight people, right? Where are we today? Hear me well. The seed structure is important, and sin is exceedingly sinful. There was no one else. So who continued to teach about the way of God? Who taught, who brought in this era of the same sins that was committed from Abraham to, Adam to Noah? The seed structure.
Yes.
So, I thank God
yes.
today. See, we think we're basically good. I'm telling you, we are a mess. We are a mess. And unless the Holy Spirit, who comes in and washes and burns out everything that's not like God. It's not all about speaking in tongues. We have played with that until now. We teach it, play with it, sell it, borrow it, create it. What? That's not what it's about. It's about a seed structure. That's what it's about. So today, I just pray that I said something that would stir up all of us to know where we are, to know who we are, and to be determined above all things to have a personal, right relationship with God. Yes. Gift or God, I want to know you. God, above all things, I want to know you. I want to be guided by you. I want to be merciful like you. I want to love like you. I want to give like you. Void of anything else, you are my inheritance. Amen? Amen. That's where we need to go. Amen. We need to renew this dynamic relationship. Amen. And that's why I talked about the glory zone. Yes. When you come into God's glory, you know it.
Yes.
Something about you dies. Yes. It's something about God's glory. Mm-hmm. That makes you shame, though you've done nothing. Why? We were born into sin. We were a sin nature. But when you come into that presence, that glory zone, that the glory of God, huh? Yeah. How many men do we know as we read the Bible that were said, when I saw God, I felt like a dead man? Why? Who can stand up in his glory? Amen. But we, you see, but he lived, he decided. He was going to fix things so he could, what? Live in us. We need to deal with that. We forget about that. We're so busy in programs and, the program has replaced the power of God. Yes. We now take it upon ourselves. We'll do this time, that time. But we, as individuals, need to renew our fellowship with God. We're already members, amen, of his body. Mm-hmm. You cannot take that away. But what about fellowship? Mm-hmm. What about fellowship? We live in a whole neighborhood forever, and we think it's great to say, whoop, I don't know none of my neighbors. I've been here 15 years. Well, that's the same as we do God. He Amen. Saves us, and we haven't heard from him in 15 years. Amen. And we in the neighborhood. Amen. So, I say that to say this, that we need to go to the glory zone. We need to get in that presence of the glory zone and to reconnect and to get the benefit of the glory of God that he gave to us and intended for us before the world was. Can we say amen?
Amen. Amen.